Hello and welcome to this continuing live coding series on creating a website from scratch with Python, Django, and the Wagtail CMS. Today we're going to be continuing a few enhancements of the community directory project, or app I should say. Get the issue over here. My Twitch chat available as well. It looks like it has moved over a little bit. Okay, cool. Essentially, we've got a basic directory, community directory of meetings. I need to do a couple enhancements there, so to speak. The decision was that we should hard code the contact types in the database, rather than letting the end user kind of specify different types of contacts through the user interface, rather than letting them define those. When we put those contact types in code, it gives us a little more control. So let's see if we go to contact, models, find my branch. I'm on the wrong branch. Ooh, it started that work. Originally, we had defined a secondary model, and we were kind of letting the end user just add documents of type, contact type, and then relating those to contacts. But that doesn't give us much. We can't anticipate particular types of contacts. Let me see. I need to rebuild, rerun this. And what we need to do is on this selection, choose a contact type. Save it. So here we go. We have these contact types and we can filter by them. And when we hard code them into the UI, which I was trying to avoid initially, we can say on this page we want to display, you know, yearly meetings, which is actually the case. When we look at the Western Friend Community Directory, which is what we're rebuilding now, this is an ongoing project. It's quite a large project, but essentially we have this directory here. And all of this top row, these are yearly meetings. In order to have that amount of control, Drupal lets us sort of define these queries in a point-and-click manner. And I sort of opened a discussion with the Wagtail developers, and they said, yeah, the Wagtail basically is oriented towards the Drupal ORM, the object relational mapper, so you define those constraints in the actual database definitions, table definitions, and templating. So in our community directory template, we'll explicitly update the query. So that's what we'll be doing today. We'll update the query here to show only the contacts of type yearly meeting. And I also wanted to run some brief updates. Let's see. It's looking like I got it changed locally, so this must be. Check my branch and open a pull request here. I wanted to update these dependencies because we have a minor security vulnerability. We're not live with this site, so it's not urgent. But let's take a look. This is the work in progress. I've been working on it for a while, kind of stepped away from it for a while. When we open the pull request, it makes it easier to track the changes and review them, see them all at one you know, within one glance, more than having to go through each file and track them down. Okay. So what we'll do is we'll try to come to the template layer and just introduce this query set that's going to grab contact types of yearly meeting. Let's add a couple more yearly meetings. It's a little bit smaller. I can use the space more effectively here. So if we come over in the contact app, actually, sorry, in the community app. There it is. This was missing. I was like, wait a minute. It's been a little bit since I've been working on this particular project. Here we go. So templates, community page. Here we are. So what we need is this. So if I edit the welcome page and add a community page. Get some boilerplate or the actual page text so it's a little more familiar. Publish. Now, when I was doing this in a more generic way, I was expecting that the editor could actually just select the yearly meetings here, but we're going to have to deprecate this and essentially make a query called yearly meetings, so I'll override the page data context. Here, the community page. And we'll make a query set. So the first thing we'll do though is just remove this. Community page yearly meetings. It was getting a little bit, a few layers of indirection there. Oops. Oh, I just collapsed it. Then we will create those migrations. Now when I refresh this page, the yearly meetings section is gone. Okay. So if we view the live version of the page, we'll just see the text and title as expected. And what we're going to do is add a query to the context. And I'll leave this upcoming events there because that's the next thing I'm going to work on. But now I need to refactored. So we get contact of type, monthly meeting, yearly meeting, excuse me. Look at the basics here. I'm not really strong with Django at the time. Query set. A little bit redundant, but okay. Contact type. It's equal to yearly meeting. Add the context directly. And now in our template, rather than iterating over the page, we'll just I believe we can just iterate over this. Yearly meetings all. We might not need the all. Double check that. Django 101 stuff, but bear with me. Yeah, it's pretty straightforward. Okay. Need to activate our virtual environment. Why didn't it get set here? I'm still in the base virtual environment. So importing it. Cool, got it. And now let's try our query. Two, That's gonna work. Now, why did it not in our context? Let's see. Okay, so yeah. If you're in the meeting, so that's why it's not getting into that block. All right, so you do have three items. Good. Returning. Why can't I access properties of them? Should be able to access these properties directly. If you're the meetings. For you're the meeting, you're the meetings, we got that. Maybe the scope is just right there. Oh, and another thing is the given name is what we're looking for. Yeah, there we are. Okay, good. That works. Now we don't have an intro text, which is another problem. We're gonna lose that. Get this layout a little bit better and then I can come back to that. Just missing the container. I don't know. This is weird why that's not working. So I believe the container's already in the base template. spacing, so we need a little bit of space between. Some utility, some margin. X, MX, 1. I wonder why I put that in a style tag, it's strange. Seems more like a typo. To come back to this intro text, I'm not sure what to do there. We went with this really generic contact model. And I'm wondering if I should do like an abstract or like an inherited model for the generic contact and have specific child models for these meetings. My queries are getting picked up here. Oh, damn. Yeah, that's right, because it was in the model. Alright. So right now, what I'm going to do is just get the intro text to be part of this model. Wagtail pages, damn. Okay, so I gotta figure out why that layout keeps going crazy. I guess you have to explicitly say the column numbers.
Which is fine.
Just gotta do those equal with. Okay, there we go. Perfect. Cool. Trying to get my code to go full screen. Sometimes you need to do that, and it makes it easier in the live stream to read the code that way. Okay, this is looking good, actually. Pretty progress. Now for each yearly meeting, I should be able to display the child meetings. Well, I have to think about that for a little bit. How we do this hierarchy of meetings. But I think that was it. I just wanted to have a quick session today and get back on track with this pull request. And I believe I'll merge this and try to run those updates in a little bit and continue with the task maybe tomorrow evening. All right, well, thanks for anybody who joined us via the Twitch live stream. And if you're watching on YouTube, feel free to leave a question or comment, and I'll follow up pretty promptly. Again, it's been a live coding series on creating a website from scratch with Django and Wagtail CMS. Thanks again for watching, and have a great day.